So from what you are seeing now, I promise you that I'm going to explain how our entire FM transmitter is working. You can clearly see the music is actually being played from the system. I will show you this. It you can see I'm only using the earphone to connect to it. There is no any connection between the transmitter and the phone. So the phone that is actually playing, look at the frequency at which I'm transmitting, 104.9. let me keep it here. I'm going to explain how everything works. So the air the atmosphere is full of air particles, but for you to put information into it, you must be able to compress the air in a way that it will be able to carry the information. This is a circuit diagram. You've heard of this concept of oscillation, that is oscillation where voltage spikes are being generated. When you generate a spike, it forces the air particles to move in a particular direction. So that process is being done with the aid of a capacitor here and a coil. How do you get the coil? The coil is very simple. This is my soldering iron. You can use any metallic object that is available that is not too big. Look at it. This is the mouth of the soldering iron. Then you get your coil, preferably a wire of 21 wg. This is it. You wrap it on it like 7 to 8 tons continuously like this. That is how we get our coil. Then you have your transistor, preferably you use a BC547, but I'm going to explain how to use other transistors with time. This is a BC547 transistor. You connect it. These two components are the actual transmission. They are the one that generated the spike for us. This is our power source, preferably 4 volts to above. So the voltage you will be pumping in will determine your frequency. This is our 4.7k resistor. The 4.7k resistor will come to the gate of the BC547. Then we have a 104 capacitor here. This one here generated the spike. This one also ensures that there is a feedback where the spike will not just stop, because at that initial stage the spike will be something like this. Look at it. So it's going to come up and it's going to be reducing. So in order to sustain that spike in a manner that it will be consistent, this capacitor must be there. We are using a 30 picofarad. I'm going to show you here. This is it. This is a small capacitor, 30 picofarad here. Look at it. You see it's written 30 on it. So this is 104. You can see it. This is 104, which is this very one. Then the one that you are going to use here is going to be 47. I've written it on it, 47. This is your 6 to 8 ton to 10 ton. This is 4.7k resistor. You have your capacitor here. Then your microphone is going to be here. This capacitor ensures that there is a smooth flow of this system. Then you have your 330 ohm resistor. This resistor is actually playing the work of a load. That is the load, so that you don't end up destroying this. You don't end up destroying this transistor. Then when you come back here, what you are having here is the same thing. This is the entire circuit, the same thing here. But I've replaced the microphone here with a 1.5k resistor, so that you don't have too much on time of the transistor. Then this very circuit is very simple. This is just a simple amplifier that ensures that the input signal is being amplified to be given to our transmitter for onward transmission. This is a 3.3k. this is a microphone here. This is a capacitor. You can use any capacitor, preferably a capacitor with a higher value small, maybe 1 UF here, and the same 1 UF here. Then you have your 4.7. this is 10k. this is 10k. this is 1k. This one ensures that you have a stable flow, that is, you don't overshoot up or overshoot down, so that you don't have cracks in the voice. That is why we have this arrangement here. Thank you very much.